Hey guys, so you guys have been asking like crazy, how do you wash your brushes? So I figured I might as well make a little video on this one. Why not, right? If it helps even one person, I feel like I've done my job, right? So what you're gonna need is your dirty brushes. Yes, I have this many brushes. I'm not washing my new wand brushes because I've used them once. They don't need to be washed yet. These, however, have not been washed in a very long time. Then you need some soap. I like to use Blue Dawn because Blue Dawn is, I mean, if it's gentle enough to wash little baby animals that have been stuck in oil spills, then it's gentle enough for my brushes. You can use just about any type of soap that you would like, but you want to have something that's gentle. A lot of people use baby soap, like Aveeno or whatever. You don't really need to use something that's that expensive. This is cheap. It comes in a really big bottle and it's multi-purpose. So that's why I use this. But like I said, lots of different options. You do not have to go and buy a brush cleaner from Sephora or Ulta or, you know, Walgreens, Walmart, whatever. You do not need all that. Then I have a towel that I use to squeeze the excess water out before I hang them to dry. And then I have the last thing that you don't really need this. Because you can, when you're washing, you can use your hand as like the scrubbing plate for, like, you take your brush and then you just scrub against your hand like that. I don't necessarily like to get my hands that dirty, especially when you have a lot of brushes. Your hands end up pruney at the end and it's not very fun. So you can buy brush washing mitts. I know Sigma has one that's really highly popular, and they make little mats, but I made my own. And I found the idea on Pinterest and I thought that it was brilliant. What you want to do is you want to find something that's waterproof. So I used this is a Pampered Chef little cutting board. It's flimsy and I like that because then it can form kind of in my sink. And then all you do is you take a hot glue gun and you hot glue on here. So like you do little dots, big dots, some squiggles, stuff like that. And then I just drew some silly stuff at the top. And that's what you're going to use as your like abrasive thing to help clean, right? So that's really about as crazy as it gets as far as the stuff that you need. And again, you don't even need this. And now let's just get into the silliness of washing your brushes. Okay, so please ignore how dirty my sink is. Whatever, not that big of a deal, right? So I just put some soap down. And then I grab a couple of my brushes. I've got a handful of them right here. What I'm going to do, so this one's my foundation brush, and it is like gross. It's needed to be washed for a while. What I'm going to do is turn on the water, let it get kind of warm. And then I'm going to put the brush underneath. Like so, and then I'm going to go in circular motions. See all of that foundation that's coming out? Super gross. Do, do, do. Rinse a little bit. Yeah, like I said, it's been a while since I've washed these. So they recommend that you wash your brushes at least once a week, depending on how often you actually use makeup. So if you use your makeup daily, once a week. If you are one of those people who does it for special occasions, you can probably go like a month every couple of months or so. It's really just kind of up to you. I apply my makeup, I wouldn't say daily, but I at least do it a few times a week. So I should be washing them twice a month, I would say. Twice a month, maybe closer to once a week. But I'm not always good about that. I should be. I think that's part of the reason why I've been breaking out as much as I have lately, because I haven't been cleaning them. And when you don't clean them, it keeps bacteria and dead skin and grossness on it, which is why you tend to break out. You also are supposed to clean beauty sponges. So let me grab mine. So there's this beauty sponge, which is, this one is a Real Techniques beauty sponge. It needs to be washed. I've only used this one a couple of times though, so I don't feel nearly as bad about it. But beauty sponges need to be washed every other or every three uses. And then you also need to actually change out your sponges. I would say every other month. Yeah, every other month. That's probably, and again, that depends on how often you're using it. If you're using it on the daily, probably once a month, you should be changing it out. There's also the Beauty Blender, which is the pink one that you can get at Sephora. They also come in different colors, which have different uses, yada, 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 whatever. I get the Real Techniques one because it is a lot cheaper and I feel like it's just as good. So anyways, Beauty Blender needs to be washed as well. Typically for this, what I will do is get it wet, like you have to for applying your makeup. And then once it's nice and wet, I'll put a little bit of soap on there and rub the soap in. And it's gonna get a little white looking. It's a lot lighter than what it normally is. And then you basically just have to squeeze out all of the soap, which takes a little while because, see, and it's mostly clean. I just half-assed it. Ta-da! Anyways, so I will now just go through the rest of my brushes and get them where they look nice and clean. I'm talking to you. Give you
Deck bicycle, come true, yo. Get you this type of blow. If you want a menage, I got a tricycle. All these bitches froze, it's my mini me. Body smoking, so they call me Young Nicki Chimney. Rappers and they feelings, cause they feeling me. I give zero fucks and I got zero chilling me. Kissing me, cop the blue box that say Tiffany. Curry with the shot, just tell them to call me Stephanie. Gun pop, then I make my gun pop. I'm the queen of rap, young Ariana run pop.
These friends keep talking way too much. Say I should give them up. Can't hear them no, cause
okay, so now what I do is I take a towel. You can use any towel. I use microfiber towels because we've got a crap ton of them. And I just squeeze and form. So you're wanting to form the brushes back to their normal look. Sometimes when you scrub them, they tend to get all like splayed looking and stuff. You want to form them back to the way that they're supposed to look, like that. So I just do that with all of them. Okay guys, so what I like to do now is I like to take a hair tie, just a normal hair tie, and I like to put it around a towel rack. Sorry, couldn't think of what it was called. And then put my brush like that. So it hangs upside down to let all the water that might be stuck in it go down, because if you put them back into their stand or whatever, like I have a cup for them, right up, the water will actually eat away at the glue that holds the bristles and you can end up ruining your brushes. So I just do this now. We'll be right back. And so now these will just hang like this overnight, and then they should be dry in the morning. I didn't show you guys me doing my eye brushes because it's the exact same process and I have a crap ton of them and I already have a bunch of those. So figured this would be good enough to show you guys. But thanks for watching, and if you guys have any more videos that you'd like me to do, just let me know. All right, bye.